Thank you, Dr. Chennai, for the nice and informative talk. Now we move on to the endowment oration. First being Dr. R. Mahadevan's endowment oration by Professor Dr. Venkata Sai. He will speak about ultrasound and sport injuries. I request the chairpersons, Dr. Subramaniam and Dr. Shanti, to occupy the chairs. Over to you, sir.
Let me introduce about Dr. Mahadevan. Dr. R. Mahadevan had a schooling at Kalatakurichi. He was born in 1918. He was a student of FMC, subsequently joined Madras Medical Service, and after getting married, he had professional appointments and retired as Dean MMC in 1956. That was followed by a stint as CMO at a plantation hospital for 17 years, where he introduced far-reaching changes and became a legend of Munnar, to be remembered by the local population even today. After expiring, he later expired in 1984 at Chennai. He had well-educated sons who were in the US, a daughter and son-in-law, of whom Dr. M.K. Srinivasan is one. During his period at Munnar, he educated and published a 200-page textbook of surgery, which was described as monumental by BMJ. This is the textbook of surgery. Needless to add that he got self-qualified during his government service and in the colleges of London, Edinburgh and the colleges of Royal College of Surgeons. Dr. Shanti will introduce the orator.
Observership training in obstetric ultrasound in Boston, USA. Observership training in MSK ultrasound in Detroit, USA. Designation Professor and HOD, Head of Clinical Services, HOCS and Senior Consultant. More than 3 decades of service in SRMC and Sridhar. Institution Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education and Research Institute, Sri Ramachandra University, Porur, Chennai. Publications, more than 69 original research papers, guest lectures, more than 129, workshop, more than 62, IRIA oration, 3, Dr. Divan Chand Agarwal Memorial Oration 2013, Dr. Miguel Mitar Memorial Oration 2018, Professor Arthur Daniel Memorial Oration 2019, IMA Oration 1, Dr. Hema Vendation Endowment Oration, IMA Chennai Kodambakkam 2015. Awards 6, recipient of the Best Teacher Award, Best Researcher Award, Academic Excellence Award, Best Radiology Teacher Award, Bharat Ratna Dr. Radhakrishnan Gold Medal Award and Distinguished Faculty Award. Areas of interest, ultrasound, MSK, dental, ophthalmic, obstetric and gynec and ultrasound guided interventions. I invite Dr. Professor Venkata Sai for give a speech on.
Thank you very much for your introduction. What I gathered from Professor S.E.S. and Mr. Narayanan, this is Dr. R. Mahadevan. He was a formerly professor of surgery in Madras Medical College and he was a doyen in medical field. He has trained a lot of surgeons and past president of Association of Surgeons of India. And he has written a book on textbook of surgery, that is the one that is 1974, that was the first textbook I believe. And this is the one, what I gathered, I am proud to present for this endowment oration. I sincerely thank the almighty president, vice president, joint secretary and treasurer, CME coordinator and all members, each and every member of the IMA Chennai Kodambakkam branch, for giving me the opportunity in 444th IMA monthly meeting. The topic which I have selected is the musculoskeletal ultrasound in sports injury. See, this year in 2019, the International Radiology, International Day of Radiology has selected a sports imaging. So in that, the lot of whatever the recent advances has happened in the sports injury has come up. So I'm proud to present it in this August gathering. See, as you all know, it is one investigation that musculoskeletal ultrasound is an extension of a physical examination for orthopedician and also for the sports physician. Not only for that, any physician. It's a popular imaging modality to identify the musculoskeletal injury and also we can do a follow-up studies. See, it has dramatically changed in inception decades ago, and the advancement in electronics and computers as a lifetime achievement award, the person was telling about the technology. Yes, it has revolutionized the practice like this. Even we can take the ultrasound to the field and then keep there without the wireless. We can do and find out whether that sprain has occurred or the rupture has occurred, or a portable ultrasound, even a handmade, that even a cell phone, we can connect the probe and then see there whether there is any injury has happened or not. That much ultrasound technology has improved. So before that, I thought I'll just two slides of the what is ultrasound. Ultrasound is nothing but a frequency of a 20,000 cycles per second and above the audible range. What I'm speaking in this area, in this hall, what you are hearing, beyond that, human audible range, what is there, 1 megahertz to 20 megahertz, we will use it for this musculoskeletal ultrasound. So there are a lot of changes have come, that linear transducer, hockey stick probe, and then we can dynamic, and then we can extend it, like an extended field of view, entire muscle we can see if there is any rupture is there, or any collection is there, that and all we can make it out in this musculoskeletal ultrasound. See, when I want to diagnose certain thing, I need a clinical history, how the injury has happened, or the what is the clinical history, and if there is any previous x-ray, that will be helpful, and a precise anatomic location, and we can identify where the tenderness on that area, particular area, we can see whether there is any abnormality is there, and we can do a dynamic action. And after that, when you interact with the clinician, we can give a better diagnosis. So what we can see, superficial, muscle, tendon, tendon sheath, ligaments, synovium, nerves, peripheral nerves, cartilage, and outer aspect of the bone. This is what we can see it in the musculoskeletal ultrasound. For example, small swelling just below the skin. This is the skin. Subcutaneous, and then one small nodule of a millimeter level, that you can identify it in this subcutaneous plane ultrasound. And you can differentiate whether it is an edema or a cellulitis, right? Cellulitis and a fluid collection, that we can differentiate it in musculoskeletal ultrasound. And this is the normal appearance of a tendon. If I take a wrist or in the tendon Achilles, you can see that is the very bright parallel collagen bundles that reflects the sound, that is the tendon, and that is the normal tendon, and the diameter increase in that tendon, we call it as a tendonitis. If there is any calcification with acoustic shadow, we call it as tendonitis with calcification, long-standing process. And some of the tendons are fixed with the synovium, surrounding synovium will be there. If there is a gap is there between the tendon and the synovium, we call it as a tenosynovitis, whether it is a clear fluid or a hemorrhagic fluid, that we can make it out in the usual MSK ultrasound. And also not only that, bursa. Yes, this is the deltoid muscle, this is a supraspinatus tendon. In between, the normally we'll have a bursa. This black one, if there is any fluid collection is there, then we call it as a bursitis. For example, this is the calcaneum, this is the tendon Achilles. In between, there is fluid collection is there that is causing pain. So that is a retrocalcaneal bursitis. K keeping the transducer in that area where the pain is there, we can diagnose this one. Not only that, sternoclavicular joint space. You can see the bone, this is the joint space, and the triangular one, cartilage area, that whatever is the cyst or a tear, anything is there, that whatever peripherally is located one, that we can make it out. And sometimes you will see an island cartilage. This is the island cartilage, that is the bone, that is the muscle. If there is any abnormality is there, that you can make it out. And a ligament, a medial collateral ligament or the lateral collateral ligament, that we can make it out. And a nerve also will have axons and the fibers. We will differentiate it that nerve has got a fascicular pattern, whereas the tendon will have a fibrillar, especially for the carpal tunnel syndrome. This echotexture will be able to differentiate this, and histologically also, tendon will have a fibrillar pattern, whereas the nerve will have a fascicular pattern, axons and the nerve fibers will be there. I will show you some of the interesting sports injury cases which we have come across. What we can see, that is rotator cuff tear, yes, shoulder, tennis, golfer's elbow, jumper's knee, quadriceps, patellar tendon rupture, Achilles tendon injuries, plantar fasciitis, muscle strains, ligament strains, tendonitis and bursitis. This is what we can see in the musculoskeletal ultrasound. All of you, shoulder is a complex joint permitting more than 180 degree. So it definitely wear and tear. Even we are doing as a doctor, we are doing lot of movement in that shoulder. You will have a shoulder pain. So there are different modalities like a plain X-ray, high resolution ultrasound, CT scan, and the MRI is there. MRI is for the soft tissues and also for the labral pathology and the Bancroft lesions like that is there. That we can make it out. Superficial one. One, we can make it out in ultrasound. For example, conventional dislocation, yes, we can make it out in the plain X-ray itself. And there is a calcification, supraspinatus tendon calcification, whether it is acute or chronic one, that we can make it out in the conventional X-ray. But beyond that, see, pathophysiology, when you look at that, see, this is the supraspinatus tendon and the musculotendinous area. That is the bursa, this is the deltoid, this is the acromion. When the movement is taking place in our shoulder joint, what will happen? This will be between these two areas, will be the two bony surface. In between, this musculotendinous portion will be going and hitting. What will happen? There will be a buckling, bursa will be there, and the inflammation will be there in the musculotendinous portion of the supraspinatus tendon. And because of this chronicity, there may be tear can occur in the supraspinatus tendon. And also, this is the tendon. You know, there is a gap in the greater tuberosity. So, inner surface of the supraspinatus tendon is more prone for the injuries. And then, when there is occurring, and then we'll see this type of injuries in the when you do ultrasound. So, here, this is a coracoacromial arch. That is the supraspinatus tendon, musculotendinous portion. It is between that one. So when there is a repeated usage causing a tendinitis, that is inflammation of the tendon, and sometimes it will go in for a calcification. X-ray also pick up the greater tuberosity area like the calcification. We'll see as a hyperechoic area with acoustic shadowing in the supraspinatus tendon. And the shoulder movements are restricted. At that time, we can do a dynamic action and then find out whether there is a, this is in the bicipital groove. This is the bicipital groove, tendon is seen, and the fluid surrounding that tendon, you can see, and this is a cross section, longitudinal section, fluid in the bicipital groove. And the tears also, we can classify, helpful for the orthopedician, whether it is a bursal type of tear, or an intrasubstance tear, or towards the articular surface tear, that we can make it out in the ultrasound. See, this is the deltoid muscle, this is the bursa, subacromial subdeltoid bursa, and this is the supraspinatus tendon, where you can see the partial tear of the supraspinatus tendon. Whereas this is a complete tear, this is the deltoid muscle, and that retraction of the fiber, and there is some amount of fluid is there, hemorrhagic fluid is there, deltoid is coming and hitting the greater tuberosity, there is an irregularity, is there, all this information, we can give it confidently to the orthopedician. And also this is the compression dynamic action, you can see that deltoid which is coming and hitting the greater tuberosity. This is the partial tear and this is the complete tear with the retraction of the supraspinatus tendon. Not only that, ball injury, when there is happening, that muscle, you can see the hematoma, hematoma in the muscle, muscle bulk, that you can make it out in this. And as you all know, all of us, even our practitioners also will come with a pain in the elbow. So tennis elbow, this is the normal one where the common tendon is inserted here, but here there is a echogenicity variation and thickness and the increased vascularity may not be seen in the x-ray, but definitely ultrasound will be helpful for that. And also treatment, after treatment, whether it is reduced or not, that we can make it out. Even in a golfer's elbow, medial aspect, you can see this is the normal tendon which is attached. And here you see there is the inflammation of the tendon and which is not picked up in the x-ray, that is common in the golfer's elbow. And also point of care, when a patient is complaining of a pain in the wrist joint, pain is there. So when you do ultrasound, just keep a transducer, you will see the tendon, these are all the tendon, and it is immersed with the lot of fluid is there and the vascularity is increased, that is called, we call it is a point of care ultrasound. So it is the tenosynovitis of the wrist tendons. Ganglion, yes, that is also common. We'll see a fluid, whether there is an internal echoes or not, infected or a simple ganglion, that we can make it out. Common, tennis leg, yes, even we play and then we'll get injured. We'll have a catching pain in the gastrocnemius muscle. So when you look at that, that is the normal fibers and the point of plane where there is a partial rupture of the medial gastrocnemius, we need at least 2 weeks of rest for this patient. Jumper's knee, yes, this is also, will come across, and then you see that insertion area, the tenderness and the echogenicity variation, then you can diagnose this jumper's knee. Not only that, tendon Achilles, rupture, yes, we can put the patient in prone position and look at the, keep the transducer here, skin subcutaneous place, that is the normal tendon. But here you see there is even a rupture or a calcification of the tendon Achilles, easily can be diagnosed. Not only that, and also muscle contusion, that this is the normal one, medial gastrocnemius muscle, whereas here there is a contusion is there, whether that is healing phase also we can make it out in the musculoskeletal ultrasound. Injury, muscle injury, where there is an echotexture chain, acute bleeding and edema is there, that we can make it out in the musculoskeletal ultrasound. This is common when we also go for a Palani Malay or the Tirupati walking. At that time we'll have a calf muscle tenderness, right? At that time when you do ultrasound, we will make it out. This is the normal appearance of the medial gastrocnemius muscle, whereas the delayed onset of the muscle soreness. See, this is the muscle soreness, the metabolites are all accumulated here and the echo texture change is there, that will lead on to the partial tear or complete tear or there like this. So that we call it is a domes, delayed onset of a muscle soreness. And a more injurious area is the myotendinous junction. This is the muscle and it is changing into tendon. So the junction of this muscle and the tendon, that myotendinous is the more common, the tear will occur in that places. And the healing, see, you may not repeat it for MRI, because you can do ultrasound and then see whether the healing, fibrosis is there. Now the elastography has come, we can find out whether that elasticity of the muscle has regained or not, that we can make it out. So follow-up is also is possible with the ultrasound. And also here, the patient will come with a pain in the abdominal area. So when you keep a transducer, not appendicitis, but we can see the muscle hernia. You see this is the muscle hernia, gap is there. When you do a dynamic action, the herniation of the muscle into the subcutaneous plane, that we can make it out by doing a simple dynamic scanning of the musculoskeletal ultrasound. Not only that,
we will do a lot of interventions. The joint pain, under ultrasound guidance, not the blind method. Under ultrasound guidance, when you put the needle, you can see where the needle is there and you can inject. Now the PRP injection, we are giving it regularly for the shoulder pain. That has got a lot of therapeutic effect for that. So it is an excellent tool, more economical than the CT and MRI. Real-time ultrasound helps in correlating with the symptomatic area. So it is the first modality in case of a sports injury. So concern about the operator reader variability, that is what the happening here, and doubts its utility and the impact on the patient care. Follow, it is very, very useful. I work in Ramachandra Medical College where we have a center for sports sciences where everything, all the sports gadgets are there, and also physiotherapy or the physio center is there, and a lot of stalwarts will be visiting our institution, and they train the champions in Ramachandra. What we see as an image, what we see is like this, garbage, but the radiologist, we interpret that as an image. So that image has got a value in musculoskeletal ultrasound.
Thank you very much, sir, for the lively and informative talk. Now I request Dr. Subramaniam to honor our orator, Dr. Ramesh Desai. I request Dr. Bhupati to honor Dr. Desai with the garden. Shanti to present the certificate of appreciation.